Hello students, myself Samadhan Patil from JIT Engineering College, Nasik. Welcome you all in the online session of Engineering Mathematics 3. Today we are going to discuss about the unit number 4. It is a vector differentiation. It is very important concept and this concept is common for all the streams. Okay. Now what type of concept we are going to discuss here. Let us start them one by one. Now the basic about the vector differentiation. Okay, those who come from the 11-12, they better know this concept because they have already studied this concept. But those who comes from diploma course, okay, they don't know the basic about this vector. Okay, now let us see the what is in by vector. The quantity which has got both magnitude and direction is called as a vector. Magnitude and direction. For example, suppose if we consider velocity, okay, so if we consider velocity, velocity has a particular direction, also it has a particular magnitude. Force is same, force in the direction of force, okay, so in the particular direction we are going to apply the force, am I right? So therefore these two quantities have both magnitude and direction, therefore these are called as what? Vector quantities. Okay, and the second one is a scalar quantity. What is my scalar quantity? The quantity which has got only magnitude is called as a scalar. There is no need of direction. There is no direction, only magnitude. For example, mass, it has no direction. Weight, it has no direction. So therefore these are the scalar quantities. Getting this? Okay, notation that we denote the vector is a vector whose initial point is A and terminal point is B is written as A, B, and its arrow. This arrow we can write over this A, B. Okay, so and it is read as A, B bar, or this is A, B bar, only dash. Okay, so instead of arrow, you can write also bar. So this is A, B bar also. Magnitude of a vector. What is in the magnitude of vector? The magnitude of vector AB bar is mod of AB bar. We can write this as in the modulus sign, mod of AB bar, and it is nothing but the length of the segment AB. Okay, so length of the segment AB is nothing but its magnitude. Okay, suppose if we start from origin up to point A, x comma y, so the distance between origin and point A is nothing but what? Its magnitude. Okay, so this is called as what? Magnitude of that vector. Or if we take this point A and point B, if we find the distance between A and B, that will be the magnitude of that vector AB bar. Okay, next is a unit vector. What is meant by unit vector? So unit vector means what? Whose magnitude is 1? Yes, it is very simple. So the vector whose magnitude is 1 is called as what? Unit vector. And unit vector in the direction of AB bar is written as AB bar divided by mod of AB bar. This is very important because the next concept that is very important is a directional derivative. Now today we are going to discuss that in this lecture. Okay. And in that concept we have to find this unit vector. Okay. So that we can find out the directional derivative. Okay. So we will discuss later about that. Next is the position vector. What is meant by position vector? See this, it is origin up to point A. This is our OA bar, vector OA bar. Okay. And if AX, Y, Z be any point in the space and O be the origin, then vector OA bar, which indicates the position of the point. This OA bar indicates the position of point A in a space. Am I right? Okay. By a vector is called as what? A position vector of A. This is the position vector of A. Why? Because this line indicates the position of A in a space. Isn't it? So therefore this is called as what? It is a position vector. So we can write this in three dimensions also with the help of three axis. See, this is x, y, z axis. X axis represent unit vector I, j-axis, y-axis represent unit vector j and z-axis represent unit vector k. So this is green, red and blue color that I have used to indicate them. So thus we can write this OA bar as a linear combination of these three vector. If A bar is x, y, z, okay, so therefore what? Therefore this OA bar can be written as xi plus yj plus zk. So this is in the linear combination of these three unit vector, where I, j, k are unit vector in the direction of x, y, z axis respectively. Are you getting this? Okay, so this is very important, because whatever the vector we have to deal in this unit, so we are going to write all that vector in this form. Okay, either xyz are here variable, either they are constant a1 a2 a3 or b1 b2 b3 or they may be xyz. Okay, it depends on the example and concept. We will discuss it. Okay, now next is the addition of vector. How we add the vector? Suppose this OA bar and OB bar, this is the two vectors. Okay, and now see this third resultant vector OC bar is nothing but the addition of these two vectors OA bar and OB bar. So this is OA bar, OB bar. OA bar represented by A bar and OB bar represented by B bar. These are the position vectors. Okay, and third vector OC bar is nothing but what? Their addition. Okay, that their addition is given by what? OC bar is equal to A bar plus OB bar. Okay, that is C bar is equal to A bar plus B bar. Actually here we are not going in detail, okay, because these are not the important concept for us. Okay, these are only the revision part, so that you can understand that how we are going to calculate them. This is the addition part, position vector. These are important, but not so far. Okay, we just use that concept for the next topics. Okay, product of two vectors. Yes, this is very important. Okay, because our total unit is depend on these two products. First is a dot product and second is a cross product. So let us see them one by one. Dot product or scalar product. What is meant by dot product or scalar product? Okay, so the dot product of two vectors A bar and B bar is defined as A bar dot B bar is equal to mod of A bar into mod of, mod means magnitude of A bar, magnitude of B bar, into cos theta. You know the cos theta. Okay, cosine angle. And what is theta here? Theta is an angle between A bar and B bar. So here theta is an angle between A bar and B bar. This is dot product. Actually, this is the definition of the dot product, basic result of dot product. But we don't use this in the further calculations. The important notes that we are going to discuss now. Okay, so first is A bar dot B bar is a scalar quantity. If we find out the A bar dot B bar, you will get a scalar quantity. Scalar means, so let me explain one more thing. So the quantity which don't have I, J, K is scalar, for your understanding. So and the quantity includes I, J, K, it is vector. Okay, so if you find A bar dot B bar, you don't get I, J, K in this calculation. So that is what scalar quantity, and therefore it is also called as a scalar product. Okay, this is a scalar quantity, therefore it is called a scalar product. Second is C, yes, cos theta. If you have A bar dot B bar, you can find out magnitude of A bar, magnitude of B bar, and if you take the ratio of them, you will get cos theta. Means with the help of this result, you can find out the angle between two vector A bar and B bar. Am I right? Okay. Next is, yes, this rule is very important, because we use this rule in this and also in the next concept, next unit, and it is what vector integration. This is very important unit also. Okay, so if A bar is A1i plus A2j plus A3k and B bar is B1i plus B2j plus B3k, then A bar dot B bar is what? A1 B1 A2 B2 A3 B3. Just take their product and add them. That will be the value of A bar dot B bar. There is no need to use this formula. Okay, so because it is, if you don't know the angle between that two vector, you cannot use this result. And in many example, we don't have the angle between that two vectors. So it is convenient to use this concept, this result, A bar dot B bar is equal to A1 B1 plus A2 B2 plus A3 B3. And it is very simple to remember also, isn't it? Okay, so with the help of this a bar dot b bar, with this result you can find out a bar dot b bar, and very simply you can find out the angle between them also. Okay, so see why I haven't written I and I here, j j k k. Okay, so this is very important question. So a bar, that I will explain in next concept. Okay, so a bar dot b bar is same as b bar dot a bar. So if a bar dot b bar is 3, then b bar dot a bar is also 3. Therefore this dot product is commutative. Commutative, the concept we know, x y is same as y into x, 2 into 3 is same as 3 into 2, 6. So that is very important. Next, also as cos theta, cos c, I'm going to answer you about this concept. I and I are, why I and I are not here, j j k k not here, because see, cos 0 is 1 and cos 90 is 0. I dot I is what? J dot j equal to k dot k is what? 1. Yes, and I dot j, because see, I dot I means what? Here, come here, magnitude value of I into magnitude value of I into cos theta. What is angle between I and I? 0. And cos 0 is what? 1. And therefore here what? I is magnitude value of I into magnitude value of I. But what is magnitude of I? 1, because it is a unit vector, and therefore what? Its value is 1. I dot j, magnitude of I into magnitude of j into cos theta. But what is angle between I and j? Yes, they are perpendicular to each other, therefore the angle between them is 90 degree, and cos 90 is 0, and therefore whole term becomes 0, and therefore the dot product between I and j, j and k, and k and I is what? 0. So you can write bar also here. Okay, I haven't used that here. Next is, two vectors a bar and b bar are said to be perpendicular to each other if their dot product is 0. Yes, if their dot product is 0, it means what? They are perpendicular to each other. This is also very important, because in irrotational field we use this concept. Okay, a bar dot a bar is a square. Dot product of a bar with itself is what? A square, because dot product with itself is, there is no angle, cos 0 is 1, and magnitude of a bar is a, magnitude of b bar is b, and b bar is also a bar. So therefore magnitude of a into magnitude of a into a is what? A square. Next is, m a bar dot n b bar is equal to m n into a bar dot b bar. And so if m and n are scalars, that we can put them outside directly and only take the dot product of vectors. Okay, next is a cross product of two vectors. Okay, cross product, also it is called as what? Vector product. So the cross product of two vector a bar and b bar is defined as what? A bar cross b bar. See, this is a notation. Cross, dot means what? Dot is there in between a and b. So here cross is, therefore a cross b is magnitude of a bar into magnitude of b bar into cos theta into n cap. This new term is here, n cap. What is in my n cap? It is a unit vector perpendicular to plane of a bar and b bar. Okay, so here it is a n cap, it is a perpendicular unit vector to the plane a bar and b bar, and theta is as usual angle between a bar and b bar. So some important notes are here. A bar cross b bar is a vector quantity, as I have already discussed, told about that a bar cross b bar contain ijk, and therefore it is what? A vector product, a vector quantity. So next is, a bar and b bar are a1i a2j a3k and a b1i b2j b3k, because every time it is not possible to find out the cross product with this rule, with this result. So therefore we have the new rule in the form of determinant. You know how to solve the determinant. First row is ijk, second is a1 a2 a3, third is b1 b2 b3. This is very simple to calculate. You can also find this determinant in with the help of calculator. Okay, next is, cross product is not commutative, because a bar cross b bar is not same as b bar cross a bar, it is minus of b bar cross a bar. Two vectors a bar and b bar are said to be parallel to each other if their cross product is 0. Okay, if cross product is 0, then they are called as what? Parallel vector. Okay, because there is no angle between them. So cos theta is 1. Cos theta is what? a bar cross n cap perpendicular vector. Okay, so therefore that a bar cross b bar is what? A bar cross b bar is 0. Why? Because if cross product is 0, it means what? Cos theta is 0. Isn't it? Okay. Next is a bar cross a bar is equal to 0. If we take the cross product of any vector with itself, then its cross product is 0 because there is no angle, and cos 0 is, yes, there is no angle between them, a bar cross a bar, and therefore that we have used. As cos theta is, cos 0 is 1, cos 90 is 0, and therefore I cross I, j cross j, all are 0. Why? Because cos 90 is what? 0. And I cross j is equal to k, unit vector. Okay. And j cross k is equal to I, k cross I is equal to j. This unit concept of unit vector, because of unit vector, this k, I and j are here. Because if you take I cross j, what is that? Magnitude of I into magnitude of j, 1 into 1. Cos theta is 90, 1. Okay. And n cap means what? Unit vector perpendicular to I and j. And what is unit vector perpendicular to I and j? Yes, k, third on the z axis. Therefore, its value is k. Same here for this j cross k and k cross I. Okay. Product of three vectors. First is a scalar triple product. It is also important. Scalar triple product of three vector a bar, comma b bar, comma c bar is denoted as, it is also called as a box product. Why? Because we have written in the box a bar, b bar, c bar, and it is defined as, see, if a bar is this a1i plus a2j plus a3k, b bar is b1i plus b2j plus b3k, and c bar is c1i plus c2j plus c3k, then what is a bar cross b bar dot c bar? This is the scalar triple product. A bar cross b bar bracket complete dot c bar, all it is can, or it can be written as in the box. This is determinant a1 a2 a3 b1 b2 b3 c1 c2 c3. This is also very simple. Just find out this determinant, because there is no ijk in this determinant, so your answer is again a constant scalar. Therefore it is also called as a scalar product, scalar triple product. Why? Because three vectors are there. Okay, some notes are here. STP is a scalar quantity, that I have already told you. Cyclic changes allowed in the STP. See, a bar, b bar, c bar. What I have done here, I have written b bar on the place of a bar on the place of c bar, and c bar on the place of b bar. See, cyclic rotation I have made. B bar here, a bar here, c bar here, and b bar here. Okay, same here. Again, that c bar comes to here. Okay, then a bar come here. And then B bar goes on the position of A bar. So these cyclic changes allowed. Second, dot and cross are interchangeable in the STP. Okay, see here, A bar cross B bar dot C bar. So we can write A bar cross and dot. We can interchange cross and dot. Still, the answer is same. A bar dot B bar cross C bar. Okay. If any two vectors in the STP are same, then STP is equal to 0. Means if we have a two identical vectors in the scalar triple product, their answer should be 0. B bar are same. Therefore, answer is same. Okay, this is also important. A bar, B bar, C bar represent volume of parallelopipe with coterminous edges A bar, B bar, C bar. Volume of parallelopipe. It represent volume of parallelopipe with coterminous edges A bar, B bar, and C bar. Okay, so this, see, this dot and cross product are very important for online exam also, because there are so many examples in the online exam related with this concept. That's why I have going in detail about this dot and cross products. Okay, if a bar, b bar, c bar equal to 0, then three vectors a, b, c are coplanar. Coplanar, they are in the same plane. Okay. Next is a vector differentiation. Dr bar by dt represent a vector derivative of r bar with respect to the scalar t, where r bar is equal to f bar of t, be a vector function of variable t. Dr bar by dt represent the vector derivative of r bar with respect to t. What is r bar here? R bar is a function of a variable t. Okay, so geometrically dr bar by dt represent the vector tangent to the curve. Because this is also important, we are use this concept in directional derivative also. If the scalar variable is time t, then dr bar by dt represent velocity vector and d square r by dt square represent acceleration vector. Here some standard rules again. We have used this rule in 12th standard also, or in diploma course also, derivative in the concept of derivative, because that rules are same: addition rule, scalar multiplication, product rule, u into v rule, u as it is derivative of v plus v as it is derivative of u. Same here, only we add the dot and cross here. Okay. Next is a scalar point function. What is meant by scalar point function? If a scalar quantity phi depends for its value on its position, say x, y, z in a space, then phi is called as a scalar point function. Okay, so that phi is called as what? Scalar point function. For example, if we take a temperature, okay, so temperature in a Mumbai, in a Nasik, they are different. Okay, so therefore temperature is depend on what? Position. So that the temperature of Nasik is different and temperature of Mumbai is different. So therefore pressure, temperature, density are the scalar point function, because why? They are depend, their values are depend on their positions. Okay, same vector point function. If a vector quantity f bar depends for its value on its position, say x, y, z in a space, then f bar is called as a vector point function. Here same, if we take the velocity, force, they have different value at the different positions, so therefore their values are depend on their positions, therefore this is called as a vector point function. Okay, because in the next concept we are going to use this scalar point function and vector point function, so it is important to know about their definition, why they are scalar point function and vector point. What is meant by scalar point function and vector point function? Okay, operator D. Okay, so whole unit is depend on this operator D, del. It is denoted by this Greek notation del, or also it is called as a nabla. We use this as only del. Okay, the vector differential operator del is defined as, see, this is very important. Okay, because we use this vector differential operator throughout this unit, and also in the for the next concept, vector integration. I dabba by dabba x plus j dabba by dabba y plus k dabba by dabba z. Okay, so this is the vector differential operator. Gradient of a scalar. What is in the gradient of scalar? If phi is a scalar point function. Okay, so if phi is a scalar point function and del operator operates on, del means vector differential operator, operates on scalar point function phi x, y, z, we get a vector function del phi, and it is called as what? A gradient of a scalar point function phi, or simply grad phi. Means what? What we are going to do here? We operate this del on the scalar point function phi. Okay, we get a scalar quantity and it is called as what? Del phi. Okay, so see here, grad phi del phi is equal to this del I double by double x j double by double y k double by double z into phi. Okay, and this is I double phi by double x plus j double phi by double y plus k double phi by double z. Some standard results we are going to discuss. Okay, first is del u plus minus v is equal to del u plus del v. Okay, these rules are same as the derivative. We have seen, you have actually seen these all rules in the derivative, u plus minus v, u into v, u del v plus v del u. Okay, u upon v rule, quotient rule, del u upon v is v del u minus u del v upon v square, del f of u, it is f dash of u into del u. Okay, so now we use this in many examples. Okay, because there are some examples depend on this rule. Okay, we will see also the proof of this rule. Okay, so actually in detail about this, you just follow my blog. I will share with you about the link. Okay, so in the end of the video. Next is same, only we replace u by r here. Okay, del r is r bar upon r. Next is del f of r is f dash of r into r bar upon r. See, whatever the fifth rule, that in the fifth rule we just replace the value of del r here, it is r bar upon r. Next is del a bar dot r bar is equal to a bar. This is also take as example, also take as a rule. We will see the proof of this also. 9 is del m of u, is m is scalar and we operate del on only u. Let us see the proof. Fourth one, okay, del f of u is f dash of u into del u. Okay, now what is del f of u? Del is vector differential operator, as we know, I double by double x plus j double by double y plus k double by double z into f of u equal to I double by double x into f of u. So this f of u is multiple with each term, okay, double by double x into f of u plus j double by double y into f of u plus k double by double z into f of u. I as it is f dash of u into dabba u by dabba x plus j f dash of u into dabba u by dabba y plus k into f dash of u upon dabba u by dabba z. Okay, so dabba u by dabba x, so f dash of u. See why? Because the derivative of f of u is f dash of u, and again the derivative of u with respect to x, because this is u is a composite function. Okay, f of u is a composite function, u is a function of x, y, z again. Therefore, dabba u by dabba x, same here dabba u by dabba y, same here dabba u by dabba z. Are you getting this? Okay. Next, see f dash of u is common in all terms. Therefore, take it as common. I dabba u by dabba x plus j dabba u by dabba y plus k dabba u by dabba z. And therefore, what is this? It is del u. This bracket is nothing but del u, f dash of u into del u. See, this is very simple proof of this rule. Okay. Similarly, we can prove the rule number 5 and 7. See, the 5 and 7 are same. Only instead of u, we have to take r. Isn't it? And r is a function of x, y, z again. But what is r actually? R is a modulus of r bar. R bar is xi plus yj plus zk. For this, okay, we will discuss about that in later examples. Now let us see the rule number 8, how to prove that a bar is, we, you know, a1i plus a2j plus a3k, r bar you know, xi plus yj plus zk, and their dot product of two vector a1x plus a2y plus a3z. See, this a bar dot r bar is a1x plus a2y plus a3z. And if we operate this del on that, del means c. Del means this one, I dabba x by dabba y dabba x dabba y dabba y dabba z. And if we take the derivative of a bar dot r bar with respect to x, partial derivative, dabba by dabba means partial derivative of this a bar dot r bar with respect to x. A bar dabba by dabba y, a bar dot r bar is b bar, and dabba y dabba z, a bar dot r bar is c bar. Okay, so this is what, this is the a bar dot a bar b bar and c bar, these all derivatives, and therefore what a bar I, this is ai plus bj plus ck, and therefore what I get, this is simply what a bar. Okay, and therefore this is a1 simply, this is a2 simply, dabba by dabba x is a1, a bar dot r bar is a1, dabba by dabba y, a bar dot r bar is b1, sorry, a2, and dabba by dabba z, a bar dot r bar is a3. Okay, sorry for this. These values are a bar, not a bar, b bar, c bar. These are a1, a2, and a3. And therefore, what? a1i plus a2j plus a3k, and this is nothing but simply a bar. So that's it. So you just follow the link, blog link, so that you can see the detailed proof of this also. Okay. Next is directional derivative. This is very important concept. So the directional derivative of a scalar point function phi in the direction of vector a bar is a component of del phi in the direction of a bar. Okay, means what? Del phi dot a cap. So find out del phi, you know how to find out the del phi, and a cap. A cap means a bar upon its magnitude value. So it is a detailed rule, del phi dot a bar upon its magnitude value. This is the directional derivative. We use this result to find out the directional derivative of the scalar point function in the direction of vector a bar. Okay, procedure for solving the problems. What is the procedure? So first, find out del phi. Phi is given, find out del phi. Second step is what? Del phi is here. You just have to put the value of phi and take the derivatives with respect to x, y, z. Second step is find del phi at given point P. Because point is also given in the example, we have to find the del phi at point P. Okay. Third step is from A bar, we have to find the A cap. Okay. But the A bar is not straightforward given. There are some conditions to find out the A bar. So first we have to find the A bar and then from that we have to find the A cap. We will discuss in the examples. Okay. And last step is what? Take the dot product of del phi dot A bar upon magnitude value of A bar and is A cap. And that is the procedure to find out the directional derivative. Let us see the first example. Find the directional derivative of phi. It is e raised to 2x into cos of yz at the origin in the direction of tangent to the curve. X is equal to a sin t, y equal to a cos t, z is equal to a t at t is equal to pi by 4. See, first step is what? We have to find what about the a bar. Forget about the a bar. First, we will discuss about the del phi. Phi is given at origin, means 0, 0, 0. P point is 0, 0, 0. Phi is given, we find out the del phi. Del phi means I dabba by dabba x into phi. So derivative of e raised to 2x into cos yz with respect to x is what? Cos yz is constant term as it is with respect to x. Okay. Derivative of e raised to 2x is e raised to 2x into 2. Same. So with respect to y, e raised to 2x is constant term as it is. Derivative of cos yz is sin yz. Actually, it is minus sin yz. And again, derivative of yz with respect to y is z. Partial derivative. Okay. And then e raised to 2x cos yz with respect to z. E raised to 2x constant term as it is. Cos yz derivative is minus sin yz. Again, derivative of yz with respect to z. It is what? Y. Derivative of z is 1 and y as it is. So this is the derivative. And if we put 0, 0, 0 means x, y, z are 0, 0, 0. If we take x is 0, e raised to 0 is 1. Cos 0 is 1. So therefore 2 into I is here. Sin 0 is 0, again here sin 0 is 0 because y is z 0. So sin 0 is 0, sin 0 is 0. These two terms become 0. So 2i plus 0j plus 0k, therefore it is 2i. So this is the del phi at 0, 0. So up to this step, you will get 2 marks. This example will be for 4 mark. So a bar is dx by dt I plus dy by dt. See, what is a bar here? A bar is a tangent to the curve. At x is equal to a cos t, y equal to a sin t, z is equal to a sin t, y equal to a cos t and z is equal to a t. These values are given in the example. So tangent means what? Dr bar by dt. Am I right? So therefore this is a bar dx by dt. Because in the geometrical meaning of vector differentiation, we have seen that dr bar by dt represent tangent to the curve. So a bar is nothing but dr bar by dt. And what is r bar? R bar is xi plus yj plus zk and its derivative is this. So derivative of x with respect to t is a cos t. Derivative of y with respect to t is a sin t. And derivative of z with respect to t is a. Because z is a t, derivative of t is 1, a as it is. So a bar at t is equal to pi by 4. What is that? Cos pi by 4 is 1 upon root 2. Sin pi by 4 is again 1 upon root 2 and a t. A as it is. So this is your A bar. This is your, treat this as U bar and find out A cap. A cap is nothing but U bar upon magnitude value of U bar. So its magnitude value, and if we calculate this, we'll get 1 by 2 I minus 1 by 2 J plus 1 upon root 2 K. And if finally, if we take dot product of del phi dot with A cap, we'll get 2 I into this. So dot product A1 B1 plus A2 B2 plus A3 B3. So 2 into 2 is 1. 0 into minus 1 by 2 0, 0 into plus 1 upon root 2 0. So therefore what? 2 into 1 by 2 is 1. Therefore direction value of directional derivative is what? 1. Getting this? Okay. So next example is to find the directional derivative. Same example is here, but the condition for a cap is different. Okay, so same with the help of phi, we can find out the del phi here. So del phi is I minus J minus 3K. I am not explaining this because already I have explained about this in previous example. So you need to focus on the direction. You need to focus on the partial derivatives only, because derivative of phi with respect to x is y square. Because yz cube is constant term, there is no x. Therefore, its derivative is 0. And here x derivative of x is 1 and y square as it is. Dabba phi by dabba y. So 2xy as it is, sorry, x as it is, because partial derivative with respect to y, x as it is, derivative of y square is 2y, so therefore 2xy is here, and y derivative of y is 1, z cube as it is, dabba phi by dabba z, so there is no z in the first term, therefore its derivative is 0, y as it is, and derivative of z cube is 3z square, and del phi here you'll get, we just put 1 minus 1, 1 in this del phi, we'll get I minus j minus 3k. Okay, now for a cap, what is a bar? A bar is a normal to this surface, and the normal to this surface means del phi. Okay, so phi 1, consider the given surface, find out del phi from that, and a bar is nothing but what? Del phi at 1, 2, 1. That I have already find, its magnitude value is root 48, and this is your a cap, and if we take the dot product with del phi, will get minus root 3. So this is the second question, second answer. Okay, see here, condition is what? If second surface is given here and our a bar is normal to that surface, normal means perpendicular, and that normal we can find with the help of this del phi. This again, del phi is normal to the given surface phi, therefore that's why we have find over here del phi. Phi is another surface, we denoted by del phi, denoted by phi 1. So del phi 1 is another is normal to the phi 1 surface, and that is our a bar. Okay, that we have already here find, and we get a directional derivative. The remaining procedure you know. Okay, so the third example is find directional derivative of phi given here at point 1, 1, 1 in the direction of line. So here again the next different condition here for a cap. Okay, so this is another different condition. So first find out del phi. Okay, so these are the derivatives. Del phi is here 12i minus 5j minus k. Okay, to find out a bar, see, consider the equation of line. This is the general rule, so that you have to note. So x minus x1 upon alpha, this is the equation of line in 2-point form, where alpha, beta and gamma are what? They are directional ratios of the line. Directional ratios maithe tumhala. So they are directional ratios of the line, and in the direction of given, and the vector actually in that direction is alpha I plus beta j plus gamma k. So the equation that I have given in the example, so alpha is 2, beta is minus 2 and gamma is 1. So therefore simply our a bar is 2i minus 2j plus k, and therefore a cap is a bar upon its magnitude value. So 2i minus 2j plus magnitude means what? Mod of a bar means what? It is root over what? 2 square plus 2 square plus 1 square. So this is, and its square root, root over 4 plus 4 plus 1, it is root over 9, and its value is 3. Okay, so del phi dot a cap, we take a dot product and we'll get what? 11, isn't it? So this is a very simple concept again. And now the next concept is, if the directional derivative of phi at 1, 1, 1 has a maximum magnitude 4 in the direction of parallel to the x-axis, find the value of ABC. Phi is given here, first find out del phi. Now what? We have given what? It has a maximum magnitude 4 in the direction of direction parallel to x-axis. Therefore, del phi is what? Del phi at 1, 1, 1 is equal to 4i. Why? Because the direction is parallel to x-axis. If direction is parallel to y-axis, we have taken this as 4j. If direction is parallel to zx, that we have taken it as 4k. Therefore it is 4i. Why? Because the direction is parallel to what? X-axis, and the value of magnitude is what? 4. And therefore this is a plus ci. And if we equate them by equal vector, two vectors, so 4 a plus c is equal to 4, b a plus b equal to 0, c b plus c is equal to 0, and if we solve these three equations, we'll get a is equal to 2, b is equal to minus 2, and c is equal to 2. So this is the solution. So in many time this example was there in the theory exam, so this is very important example. So solve the following examples at home, try these examples, all the type of examples we have taken, you need to only focus on the partial derivatives and the procedure that we have discussed. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the gradient. We will discuss about the curl of the vector point function f bar. Then some vector identities we will discuss, and some results also we have to see. And example based on that, irrotational field also we will discuss. Okay, thank you. So